Use motion to improve your videos by calling attention to specific items on screen with a callout title. Start by creating a new motion project. Final Cut Pro was used to export this clip to the desktop. In it, a snowboarder is explaining her equipment, and we are going to use motion to help. Drag the video into the project pane to add it as a new layer. As you add more elements to your project, keep it organized by renaming and grouping layers. Adjust the project duration to match the video clip. Enable the rectangle tool. Click and drag to create a new shape layer that covers the first piece of equipment. Press Escape on the keyboard to activate the transform tool. Use the HUD to disable the fill color, enable an outline, and increase the width. Since the transform tool is active, click and drag the edges to resize and move the shape to create the desired frame. After the outline is drawn on the screen, text with the name of the piece of equipment will be displayed next to the item. A line can be used to direct viewers' attention to where the text will appear. Enable the Bezier tool from the Canvas toolbar. Click to add the first point where the line will start. Click again to add the second point. Then, while holding Shift, click to add the third point. Holding Shift causes the line to be drawn at the nearest 45-degree increment. Press Return to complete the line. Use the HUD to adjust the line to match the size and color of the outline. If needed, adjust the control points at this time. Then, switch back to the Transform tool. Press T on your keyboard to enable the text tool and click on the canvas to enter the desired text. Press Escape and use the HUD to adjust the text as desired. Press the I at the top right of the HUD to access additional controls using the inspector. With the desired look created, it's time to animate with behaviors. Hold Command and click on the rectangle and Bezier layers to select them. From the toolbar, click Behaviors, Shape, Right On. Press the space bar and notice the rectangle and line are slowly being drawn onto the screen, as if someone is doing it with a pen. Adjust the duration and position of the Right On behaviors using the timing pane. Select the right-on behavior for the rectangle and adjust the stroke offset, render a RAM preview, and play back the project. The RAM preview ensures we get a smoother playback, and the change in stroke offset causes the drawing of the rectangle to happen from the top right. Behaviors usually save time, but in some cases, manually creating a desired animation by adding keyframes to a parameter is needed. Let's add keyframes to the crop property to animate the letters as if they are growing from the line as it's drawn. To add a crop property, select the text layer, click Object, Group. Open the Properties Inspector for the new group to show crop. Carefully increase top until the text is completely cropped. Try not to increase the amount by too much, or you'll have issues with the animation. Next, move the playhead to the moment you want the text to start growing. Next to the top property, press the Add Keyframe button. Move the playhead forward to the moment all of the text should be displayed. Adjust the top property to 0. Playback the project. The animation is starting to look better, but the animation is not beginning or ending at the correct times. Fine-tune the timing of the keyframes by showing the keyframes in the timing pane. The letters at the end of the word are growing before the line gets to them. Following the same steps, add a pair of keyframes to the group's right crop property. Spend as much time as you need to perfect the look of this callout. Then, group the elements of the callout together. Make sure the video is not included in the group. Duplicate the group a few times until you have the desired number of titles for each piece of equipment. Use the timing pane to adjust the placement in time of each group and the canvas to improve the position. Continue to play back your project to understand how each change is impacting the look of the project. Use the checkboxes to the left of the group layers to hide layers you are not currently working with. Don't be afraid to go back and make adjustments to any layer, as we are doing here to update the text for each new piece of equipment. Once completed, click Share, Export Movie to create a movie that can be imported into a Final Cut Pro project. Motion is available in the Mac App Store for $49 and is an excellent tool for any Final Cut Pro editor. Want to learn more? Pick up a copy of An Awesome Guide to Motion, available from the iBook Store and Amazon. Have a topic you'd like me to cover? Leave a comment or send me an email, finalcutprohelp@me.com.